Hey everyone, this is James Roguski, and thank you for visiting thepeoplesamendments.com. The purpose of this article and website and this action is to write amendments to the international health regulations, both to be submitted to the World Health Organization for consideration by the World Health Assembly, but probably even more importantly, to clearly define terms that are being stolen in the language. The world is using language in a way that's actually being weaponized. And the very first article in the world, I'm sorry, in the international health regulations are definitions of terms. Now, we've all come across words like safe and effective and vaccine and pandemic and case and things like that, that we know are ill-defined, they're not defined in the law, and they're being used against us to start things like a case-demic, where, oh, everybody passed got a positive result on a PCR test, therefore there's some emergency that must be addressed. Now, in addition to that, the very first section of the proposed pandemic treaty lists a number of words that are openly admitted by the World Health Organization, are not defined. And so this website, this article right down below, you'll find many words, and people are welcome. Everyone who's visiting this page is welcome to, in the comments, or we have a daily Zoom meeting. You can certainly chime in during the Zoom meeting or join the Telegram chat and put in your suggestions for how these words should be defined. Now, a lot of people say, and on one level, I absolutely agree, we need to leave the WHO, we should disband the WHO, we should not negotiate with terrorists, we should not participate in this process. And those are somewhat valid arguments. But most people who make those arguments have not actually read the international health regulations. So before anyone makes a comment to that effect, which on many levels I do agree, I encourage everyone to take the time to scroll down to where all of the documents are at the bottom of this page, all the source materials, and take the time to read the international health regulations with the realization that they are currently international law. They are legally binding. For the most part, they enable the WHO to make recommendations. And for the most part, they act as shackles constraining the power of the World Health Organization. That's why they want to amend them. They want to unshackle themselves. They want to add in more legally binding authority, taking sovereignty away from we the people and the individual nation, member nations of the WHO. And so before commenting, please inform yourself as to what the international health regulations are, why some of it needs to be more strongly enforced because the WHO is stepping beyond their bounds, and realize that we the people have the right to let it be known how we wish these international health regulations could be better. The delegates from all of our nations are speaking in our name. They are submitting proposals for new amendments. The deadline was actually September 30th of 2022, and they're doing so in secret. And so there will be a link down below in terms of calling out the WHO and calling out all of our individual nations, members, and delegations for doing this against the will of the people. We the people submitted well over 33,000 comments back in April saying we don't want a pandemic treaty, and they have not even given us the opportunity to say we don't want amendments to the international health regulations. They tried to do this, the Biden administration and other nations tried to do this earlier in the year, in April and May, leading up to the World Health Assembly, the 75th World Health Assembly in May of 2022. And those were rejected, although a replacement set of amendments were adopted. Most people are completely unaware of that. And that's what needs to change. The negotiations for the pandemic treaty are very, very real. They're very much of a concern to everyone on the planet, but they are also acting as a decoy and a distraction for what is currently happening in secret in regards to the Working Group for Amendments to the International Health Regulations, WGIHR. I encourage everyone to read all of the information on thepeoplesamendments.com, and you can contact me anytime, 310-619-3055. I look forward to your input, your suggestions, your ideas for how we, the people, can take back the language and define terms that are no longer, so that they will no longer be able to be used this against us as weapons. And so participate, because silence is consent. And if you just push this off to the side and do nothing, then they will feel that they have an open field to run in, and we'll get what they want rather than ensuring that we get what we, the people, demand. Thank you.